Dear friends and comrades, I'm really happy to have the opportunity to welcome you tonight at something which is called Die Schule der politischen Hoffnung. I think this initiative is hugely important, especially in the dark times we are living today, where we can see that it is precisely Hoffnung, it is precisely hope, which is disappearing. If you ask millions of refugees displaced from Syria, Yemen, and other war-torn countries what kind of hope do they have, they would probably answer you that they don't have any kind of hope. If you look at the recent climate disasters from hurricanes Irma to Harvey, if you look at the wars which are still taking place, if you look at the austerity measures at the periphery of the European Union, or even if you look at the problems which are present in the daily life of German citizens as well, what you will see is precisely that a kind of hope that there is a future at all is disappearing. This is the reason why I think it is so crucial to stage and organize events such as this today, because if in the climate where institutions such as universities or theaters, just take a look what happened to the Volksbühne in Berlin, if these institutions don't have the ability anymore to educate us, to provide what you call politische Hoffnung, political hope, then it is us, the citizens, the students, the workers, the mothers, the fathers, the friends, the lovers, who have to organize and who have to self-educate. It's not the first time in history, definitely, and it's certainly not the last time. And this situation, to end with a picture, how to picture yourself tonight, and me as well from the other corner of Europe from which I'm sending you this picture, there is a nice science fiction post-apocalyptic trash movie, I would say trash, but I still like it, from 1997, produced and directed by Kevin Costner. It's called The Postman, and it depicts a dystopian future in the United States. After the collapse of civilization, there is a civil war going on, and there is a constant state of exception, similar to the political concept described by Carl Schmitt. So everyone against everyone, homo homini lupus, and so on. In this situation, there is the main character played by Kevin Costner, who completely incidentally finds a uniform of the United States Postal Service. He puts on the uniform and he goes from village to village convincing people that the American government is restored and that even the Postal Service is working. This is of course not true at all. There is no United States, there is no government, and of course there is no post. But the people start to believe, although what is really interesting, and I think some of us are in this position today as well, that Kevin Costner, the main character, himself doesn't believe in the postman. But the people who start to receive the post and who start to receive the news that there is something like a restored government and post, start to believe in the postman. And it is precisely by this belief, by this renewal of hope, that a new resistance movement was born in this dystopian future. I think today, to finish, we are in the same position. We are just in front of a collapse of civilization, be it ecological disasters, be it new wars, be it new refugee crises, be it something what is even worse, which is this constant normalization of something which is not normal, this permanent state of exception. And I think it is our role today to be, as Kevin Costner was in The Postman, those who will bring hope, and there is no one else to wait on. It is only us, and it is up to us to provide something what you nicely call politische Hoffnung. I'm really sorry not to be with you tonight, but I'm sure I will join you at one of the next events. And be sure that there are many, many people like you all over Europe, but they just need to be connected.